This is Jules, and these are the technology news you need to know about for the week ending August 4. Ubisoft opens new Philippines studio. French game developer and publisher Ubisoft officially opened the doors to its Philippines studio located inside the De La Salle University Science and Technology Complex in Santa Rosa, Laguna last July 27. Housing over 100 local game developers, the facility is the first AAA game studio in the country. Ubisoft first set up shop in the country 2 years ago in a smaller space within the same campus, hiring up to 50 people in its first year to co-develop titles such as Assassin's Creed Origins, For Honor, and the recently released The Crew 2. Now that the team is 100 strong, the company proudly announced that they are helping to develop upcoming titles including Assassin's Creed Odyssey and Skull and Bones. The company, however, is still looking to expand their roster of talent as they look to hire 200 game developers in the coming years. University of the Philippines Cebu improves taxi hailing experience with technology. Commuters have always complained with the way taxi cabs are operated in the country, and the public sector can only do so much to address the issue. With the assistance of the University of the Philippines Cebu, a startup company has risen to the challenge. According to the announcement made by UP, MiCab has given commuters an alternative to old-school taxicab fleet and management hailing. UP Cebu Business Incubation for IT lent its helping hand to the startup company and gave it a home since January 2015. The University of the Philippines has provided MiCab its home as well as scientific and entrepreneurial network support to its 20 regular and freelance staff. At present, MiCab is known as an internet-based taxicab hailing application that has been introduced into national consciousness in the wake of Grab's takeover of the country's transport network vehicle service private fleets. Philippines targeted in latest attack. Fortinet, an integrated and automated cybersecurity solutions company, has discovered a resurgence of the Husarini malware in the Philippines that exploits a vulnerability in Microsoft Office. Also known as SAR-HURST, this backdoor malware was last seen in 2014, targeting various countries in Southeast Asia. Fortinet's FortiGuard Labs identified Husarini in a malicious document with a politically themed file name. This malware is classified as an Advanced Persistent Threat or APT attack and attempts unauthorized entry into computer networks to potentially steal data. Analysis by FortiGuard Labs researchers indicates that it is by no coincidence that cybercriminals are targeting the Philippines in the renewed APT attack campaign. In 2016, the Philippine government suffered a major attack on its Commission on Elections database that compromised personal information of over 50 million voters. Cybercriminals had in the past exploited known website vulnerabilities to launch their attacks. The Philippines, with a huge number of internet users with little to no knowledge about cybersecurity, is very vulnerable to cyber attacks. Australia, UNDP, PhilDev launched mentorship for social enterprises. The Australian Embassy, the United Nations Development Programme, and the Philippine Development Foundation have partnered to deliver a world-class mentorship program for innovative social enterprises in the Philippines. The Innovation for Social Impact Partnership, or ISIP, is a three-year project that aims to support promising social enterprise startups to grow and become globally competitive, contributing to broader and inclusive economic growth in the Philippines. The project will provide technical support and improve capacity to access capital and attract impact investors. UNDP Philippines Country Director Titon Mitra said the partnership will support some of the most innovative Filipino social enterprises in their early stages of business development to become sufficiently bankable so that they can attract funding from impact investors. In line with ISIP's strategy on entrepreneurship, applications are now open for the Social Impact Accelerator. The Innovation for Social Impact Accelerator is an intensive 6-month program where selected social enterprises will receive free network and mentorship support that will allow them access to markets, talent, capital, and guidance from world-class mentors, advisors, and partners. GDPR in the Philippines to boost business dealings with the EU. The implementation of the General Data Protection Regulation, or GDPR, in the Philippines will benefit more organizations as this will enhance their transactions and dealings with EU-based businesses and citizens because they have data privacy and transparency measures in place. The new regulation applies to all organizations that operate in the EU and/or processes the personal information of EU citizens regardless of their size or location. In this light, companies based in the Philippines but engaged in businesses involving EU citizens must comply with the regulation. The GDPR, which took effect last May 25, requires companies and other organizations operating the EU, wherever they are based, to practice greater transparency and vigilance in accessing and collecting consumers' personal data. GDPR is regarded as the most significant change in data privacy regulation in 20 years, which will see drastic changes in the way of doing businesses worldwide. The regulation draws greater transparency from organizations that process personal information and, at the same time, grants consumers more control over their data.
These have been the tech news this week, here in the metro and in the country.